Have you ever wondered how those massive show-stopping orchids get their incredible size and vibrant colors, while the same orchid with the same name without the classification of 4N in the name seems to still be nice, but not as nice as the one that has 4N next to its name? Also, why does the one classified as 4N have a higher price tag? Let's just scratch the surface of the world of plant hybridization, specifically focusing on the fascinating realm of 4N genetics. Because while usually 4N orchids are coveted for all the reasons I just mentioned, and for that reason they are usually more pricey as well, I happen to have a Vandica stylus loose sneery blue that comes with the other side of the coin when it comes to hybridizing for bigger, better growth, more vibrant colors, vigor, strength, and resilience to pests. I call this orchid my weirdo. And if you're new to my channel, please know that since I received this orchid in 2018 and after its first blooming showed many abnormalities, I have taken measures to see if my orchid just needed a total reset to get a normal grow and bloom on again. So the first year after the first blooming, I eliminated seaweed completely while continuing to fertilize at an ideal concentration. Seeing as seaweed is packed with growth hormones, overdosing on seaweed can also result in deformed blooms and spikes. However, the following year, the blooms and spikes were still deformed. So in that year that followed after that second blooming, I did not fertilize this orchid for the entire year, neither did I use seaweed. This way I could eliminate any possible influences when it came to my care and see what would happen next. Yet again, the spikes and blooms were deformed. I have also eliminated the possibility that this orchid has a virus because it is growing so vigorously, a virus would weaken the orchid over time. So I resorted and concluded that this orchid has been bred for all the wonderful characteristics of a lucernary, and they wanted to supercharge this hybrid. However, mine turns out to be a dud in that regard, with the exception of the fragrance. While the classic lucernary has a sensational fragrance, when this weirdo blooms, the fragrance throw and intensity is off the charts, which is another result of 4N genetics, supercharging the good traits and getting the orchid to deliver as if on steroids. In all these years, this orchid has always been exposed to excellent light, and to see if my orchids needed more moisture than I could provide in the basket with lava rock, I capped the top fan off, checked for fusarium, which we could eliminate, and I have the top fan growing in lecca and self-watering, which is obviously more water retentive, but still, even with all those adaptations, this orchid still blooms with deformed blooms. So now you might be thinking, what on earth is 4N? Well, it's all about chromosomes. Most plants are diploid, meaning they have two sets of chromosomes, but 4N plants, also known as tetraploids, have four complete sets. This extra genetic material can lead to some pretty amazing changes and enhancements and improvements, or, as in my orchid, unwanted changes, also known as the boomerang effect. Hybridization and 4N hybridization, or crossbreeding different orchid varieties, can naturally lead to polyploidy, including tetraploidy. This happens when chromosomes from both parents get a little mixed up during the breeding process. For what that is worth, I felt it right to point that out in a video like this. However, this lucernary, the parents of which are Rhynchostylus gigantea and Vanda falcata, the issue with mine is not the crossbreeding of different orchid varieties. Now, why do we care about 4N plants in general? In our case, orchids specifically. Well, they often come with some serious perks, as mentioned. They have supersized growth, so 4N plants tend to be bigger and stronger than their diploid counterparts. Imagine those orchids with even more massive blooms. Massive being relative to the size of the orchid, of course. You can see that while these blooms are deep formed, they are a tad larger, and to the touch, they are much more robust in texture than the classic lucernary. They also last 2 weeks longer than the standard lucernary. Speaking of supersized growth, these fans are hard as nails. So much so that I had one leaf in a fan piercing through another leaf instead of growing up and out in a normal way. When that leaf was released from where it was growing through the other leaf, the fan has progressed as it should. But wow, this orchid definitely has a mind of its own, and it is tough as nails. Typical for when they consider added strength in a 4N hybrid. 4Ns also display novel traits when hybridizing, and polyploidy can create exciting new combinations of traits, leading to unique flower colors, patterns, and even disease resistance, which is clear with the color of the blooms on this orchid. They have a hologram effect on them. If they had turned out perfect, this orchid would be a stunner in how the blooms change color within themselves because of that exaggerated hologram effect. However, the disease-resistant part, I would like to caution against claiming that 4N are more resistant to disease. It is always within the environment and care that we cannot rely on any orchid being completely disease-resistant, and mine happens to remind me of that when it comes into bloom, because the mealybugs would love to infest this orchid given a chance. If you have, or if you decide to purchase 4N orchids, please do not rely on the disease-resistant trait. 4N does not guarantee health, clearly. Now, while I have already mentioned and shown you the downsides of what can happen with an orchid that is labeled as 4N, let me briefly say that other downsides 4N orchids can sometimes experience are reduced fertility. While fertility often is increased in 4Ns, the opposite can be true as well, and fertility can be reduced or become unstable. And seed set challenges, then producing the seeds, can be much more trickier for 4N orchids as well. I do not want to discourage anyone from getting their hands on 4N orchids. The takeaway from this video is to explain what it means to see 4N on your tag behind the name, why you are seeing a higher price tag, and what can you expect from paying more for a 4N orchid, but also that there is the possibility that you may get a dud, like my weirdo here. So the next time you see 4N at the end of the ID of your orchid, and you admire that spectacular orchid ready to take it home, remember the science behind the remarkable beauty and what makes it unique to the same orchid that is not bred to 4N. Ideally, you want to have it in bloom when you purchase it, A, to be sure you are actually getting a 4N, and B, it's not just added to the name as a justification to hike up the price and scam you out of your hard-earned money. Of course, it's always nice to be able to trust the seller, that the seller is above board, and you can purchase a 4N labeled orchid with confidence in the knowledge that the seller would not sell you a 4N orchid unless it truly is 4N, and definitely not con you out of your hard-earned money should you buy yourself a seedling or a juvenile, also known as near blooming size orchid. So let me know if you have any questions. This was really scratching the surface when it comes to 4N. Hopefully next time you see a 4N, you'll know exactly what you can expect. In the meantime, please take a moment to give this video a thumbs up, and I would really appreciate you for subscribing to the channel. Thank you so much, and thank you for watching this video to the end, giving me the opportunity to wish you a wonderful day. I do attach a condition to that, though, that you stay safe, please. Take care. Bye.